Welcome to the second hour of This Morning. Here are today's headlines. The people of Myanmar are thanking Koreans for supporting their protests against the military coup, many of them using hashtags Thank You Republic of Korea for supporting the Myanmar people in Korean, and also thanking the Korean media for covering the local situation after the junta imposed martial law. President Moon Jae-in has condemned violence by Myanmar's military and police and called for restoration of democracy and peace in the country. A number of civic and religious groups of Korea have also followed suit. Seoul has imposed sanctions and export controls in response to the coup. 335 late prisoners who were wrongfully convicted of inciting insurrection and sentenced to prison in the military courts without due process in 1948 to 1949 during the April 3rd uprising and massacre were exonerated after more than 70 years. The Jeju court ruled the late defendants, who were either massacred or missing during the Korean War, were not guilty. Park Young-soo, the bereaved son of the late Park Se-won, bowed to the court on behalf of the freed souls and said the absolution verdict will live in history. The Ministry of Culture, Sports and Tourism confirmed suspicions that several newspaper companies, including Joseon-Ilbo, received additional government subsidies by exaggerating their net paid circulation numbers. As a result of the investigations, the ministry revealed that it will restrict ABC from interfering in the reporting process of specific newspaper companies and require the body to come up with a separate set of guidelines to ensure a fair selection of sample locations and verification methods. The ministry has given ABC until the 30th of June to follow its recommendations. Finally, the Joe Biden administration is reportedly planning the first major federal tax increase since 1993, raising the corporate tax rate to 28% from the current 21% after former President Donald Trump lowered it from 35%, as well as increasing income taxes for individuals earning over $400,000 a year is under consideration, according to Bloomberg. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki said Biden shares Elizabeth Warren, the senator's perspective on the wealth tax, which introduced an ultra-millionaire tax proposal in Congress. And you can listen to these headlines once again on our YouTube channel by searching TBS eFM. Once there, you'll also get a script of the headlines and subtitles as well. Coming up next, we're going to discuss BTS's historical Grammy performance as well as the prospects for Minari's Oscar win.